Philip Adams was interviewing people who lived along the Darling and Murray River. He was going down on a houseboat and just kind of getting stories from the river. Amazing stories of life on the river. And I was just literally driving along Riverside Drive in Perth, and I thought, this would make an interesting kind of epic play. You know, I like a good old journey story. And I love stories of the land, and I like people who are fighting against overwhelming odds. I then hired a van, drove down, a rental Apollo van, drove down up to Bourke from Sydney, all the way to Bourke, drove down the Darling River, stayed along the river and just talked to people and by myself, and stories started to come out of that experience. This the true story of a part of the Darling River where the water was getting lower and lower and lower, but the history of the land was coming up as the water got lower. So some Aboriginal bones were found close to Lake Alexandrina, and therefore, with further investigation, it was discovered to be a massacre site. To get that epic nature in such a small space. But that's the thing, as I said to you the other day, the reading that's exciting me. That there is a compression of the epic proportion of the play. So all the ideas and all the big ideas are kind of contained in the actors. It's a huge challenge for the actors and the designer and bloody everybody, really. But just to get that epic nature of the piece in such a small space. The first play I ever wrote was designed just specifically for the Griffin. It was set in a train. Little did I know that the next play I ever wrote would be the biggest landscape I've ever written and would still be in the Griffin Theatre. But hey, it'll work.